permanent resistance between P and Q. Okay, so let's redraw this circuit. Actually, point P and B are same because there is wire between these two points. So this point is also actually P. This point is also actually Q. Okay, because there is wire between these two points. Now let's redraw this circuit diagram. This point is also A. This point is also P. This point is also Q because this is direct wire. Okay. So let's redraw the circuit diagram. Suppose this is P and suppose this is Q. And always assume a battery between those two points about which you want to find equivalent resistance. Okay. And suppose this is point A. Suppose this is point A. Now this resistance is between P and A, and this resistance is also between P and A. Means there are two resistances in parallel between P and A. Right? R, R. Now let's look at this resistance. This is between P and Q. This is also between P and Q directly. Two resistances are in parallel between P and Q. R, R. Now this is between A and Q.
So
this
R
is
by
also
three.
Between A and Q. R by 3. This is R, this is R. No, I think you are wrong.
3R by 2.
Maybe I don't know. These two will become R by 2. Agree? This will become R by 2. This will become R by 2. And this will also become R by 2. Right? So your equivalent resistance will be R by 2. R by 2. This R by 2. Now you can solve this.
R by 2.
So this will R and R by 2 are in parallel. Now what you will do? Upper product, niche sum. Product in numerator, sum in denominator. 2 got cancelled. Yes, R by 3 is correct answer. R by 3. Understood? Now next question. Look like this. Suppose this is point A. All resistances are equal in value. Find equivalent resistance between A and B. Find equivalent resistance between A and B. All resistances are equal. How will you start solving? Let's look at these two. These two are in series, so this will become 2R, right? This 2R is in parallel with this R, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this 2R and R will become 2R into R upon 3R. So it will become 2R by 3. So at the place of this whole circuit, we can place 2R by 3. Am I right? Now let's assume a battery between A and B. Assume a battery between A and B. And one corner is 2R by 3. Let's redraw the circuit diagram. When we'll redraw the circuit diagram, we'll get 1R between A and B. We made this. Okay. Now at the place of this, we'll make 2R by 3, okay? 2R by 3. At the place of this, we'll make 2R by 3. At the place of this, we'll make, tell me 2R by 3. Am I right? At the place of this, we'll make 2R by 3. Now, if you look at the circuit carefully, these two 2R by 3 are in series. And these two 2R by 3 are in series, right? So what you'll get? 4R by 3, 4R by 3 and R, right? Finally, you'll get R. Here 4R by 3 and here 4R by 3. Between A and B. So what will be your answer? 1 upon R plus 1 upon 4 by 3 plus 1 upon 4R by 3. This is 1 upon R equivalent. Okay. Take 1 by R common. You'll get 1 by 1 plus 3 by 4 plus 3 by 4. What will be your answer, bacho? What will be your LCM? 4. 4 plus 7. So your final answer is 4R by 11. Understood everyone? Okay, let's move towards our next question. Find total resistance between X and Y. Next question is saying that find total resistance between X and Y. The circuit looks like this. This is X, this is Y. This is 8 ohm, this is 4 ohm. This is 6 ohm, this is 2 ohm, and this is 4 ohm. Find equivalent resistance between X and Y. If equivalent resistance between A and B is 18 ohm, then what is value of R? Solve it seriously, fast, quickly. This is our previous question. What we can do, let's try to find equivalent of these three, assuming that R, okay, these two 10 ohm will become, what I can write here, 10 ohm in parallel, what will become at the place of these two, what we can write, 5 ohm, very good. Here we can write 1 5 ohm. So we are adding 1 5 ohm at the place of 2 10 ohm, 5 ohm, right? Now these two, 5 and 10 will become 15, right? Right?
15.
So this become 15. 15 ohm. Now this 15. Now why this much big wire we are using? Let's use a small length of wire. Okay? Let's apply 15 here directly. Understood?
16 ohm.
Understood? I don't know answer. 16 is there in the option. Bacho, what will get resultant of these two, 15 and 10? Product upon sum. Sum is 25.
6 ohm.
6 ohm. Correct. So at the place of these two, I will connect 6 ohm, right? At the place of these two, I will connect 6 ohm. This is 6 ohm. No, at the place of these two, I'll connect 16 ohm, right?
Yes, sir.
This is 16 ohm. Okay. Now 16 ohm and R in parallel. So we will get, product upon sum at the place of these two, right? Let's remove this. And connect this 16R upon 16 plus R. Agree? Now 10 plus 16 R upon 16 plus R is equal to what?
18.
If you solve this, 16 R upon 16 plus R is equal to 8. This will come
to R is equal to 16.
R is equal to 16.
Correct. 16 plus R, so R is equal to 16. Okay. Understood how we did that?
Yes, sir.
No. Oh. Few more questions, Bachu. This is point A. Resistance is R. This is also R. This is also R. And a wire kept like this. Another wire connected here and here. And another wire connected here. R. This is B. Okay. Can you solve this question? If there is wire between two points, those two points must be same, right? So this is A. This is also A. This point is also A. This point is also A. This is also A. 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 So I think these all resistances are connected between A and A. So answer is only R. Resistance between A and B is only R. Because all other are short circuited. I'll explain you. Wait, don't worry. Let's make A and B. Let's talk about this resistance. This resistance is between A and B, okay? Now this resistance is between A and A. This is called short circuit. This is called short circuit. Remove this from the circuit, okay? Now this also is between A and A. That is also short circuit. R and R, short circuit. This is also between R and R. Between A and A, short circuit. So our final answer is only R. Understood, bachcho? Interesting, no? I don't know why you all are not responding suddenly. Stop the responding because maybe questions are so easy. Okay. One more question. Last question based on the... No, not last question. Last question on level 0. Okay, next question is... This is 2 ohm. This is 3 ohm. This is 20 ohm. Okay. This is 15 ohm. This is 16 ohm. This is 4 ohm. 20 ohm. 50 ohm, 30 ohm. Now answer this question. Find equivalent resistance between A and B. I will not solve this. Take it as a homework. Take it for your homework. Can you do it by your own, Sinchana?
Yes.
Can you do it, Sinchana? Okay. Write wheat stone bridge. Write basics required. basics required. First basic required is current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. Okay, bacho, do you remember this? Current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. Okay. If potential between two points is same, then current will not flow between these two points. Okay, like this. Remember these two basics. Okay, current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. If potential between two points is same, then the current will not flow between these two points. Okay, any doubt in this?
No,
now what,
sir.
What is Wheatstone bridge? Wheatstone bridge, it's a very complex network of resistance. It's a very complex network of resistance in which we cannot find direct series or parallel combination. Okay, in Wheatstone bridge, stone bridge, there is no direct series or parallel combination. तो बच्चों जब भी तुम्हें ऐसा सर्किट दिखे जिसमें ना तो सीरीज दिख रहा हो ना तो पैरेलल दिख रहा हो, समझ जाना कि वो एक Wheatstone ब्रिज है. ठीक है? In Wheatstone bridge, there is no direct series or parallel combination. Now let's see how it looks. How it looks like. Suppose this is resistance P. Value of this resistance is P. Okay. Value of this resistance is Q. Value of this resistance is R. Suppose value of this resistance is S. PQRS. Okay. And there is another resistance, another, you can say galvanometer. There is a galvanometer like this. Okay. And there is a battery like this. Battery connected like this. But so this is known as Wheatstone bridge. This is how it looks like. Okay. Where PQRS are four different resistance, are four resistance where we can put any value of resistance. Okay, you can put any value of resistance at the place of PQ and RS. Okay, suppose you, in your mind, if you want to keep 1 ohm at the place of P, put 1 ohm. Okay, do not give any random, do not give any value. Okay. Suppose I current is coming from the battery, bachcha. Suppose capital I current is coming from the battery. So some current will go upward, right? Suppose I1 current is flowing through P. So what will be potential drop here? Can you tell me? I1 into P.
Yeah.
I1 into P. And suppose out of I1 going there, suppose I2 current is going here. So what is potential difference across R? I2 into R. Okay. Now I1 current was going. I1 current was going here. Out of I1, suppose some current IG going down. Suppose some current IG going down. So how much current is left? Out of I1, IG is going down. How much current is left? I1 minus IG. Okay. And what is potential drop across Q? I into R. Resistance is Q and current is I minus IG. Agree? So IG current is coming down like this. How much current will flow through S? Can you tell me? How much current will flow through S? Can you tell me, bachcho?
IG.
I2 plus IG. Right? I2 plus IG. And what will be the potential drop across S? V is equal to IR, right? S into I2 plus IG. This will be the potential drop across S. Any doubt in this question till now?
No, sir.
But so suppose this point is A. Suppose this point is A and this point is B. Suppose. Now, this is a Wheatstone bridge. If this bridge is balanced, right at balanced condition, there will be no current through, no current will flow through galvanometer. Right? At balanced condition, when bridge is balanced, no current will flow through galvanometer. Agree? Now, balanced means no current is flowing through galvanometer means what? Means potential at A must be equal to potential at B. Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Current, if potential between two points is same, then current will not flow between these two points. Agree? So bridge is said to be balanced when potential at point A and point B is equal. Now, why these potential are equal? Because I'll keep putting different values of resistance until I achieve this. I achieve IG zero. Okay, suppose I am doing an experiment and I am changing resistance again and again. I am changing resistance P again and again, and I am changing resistance Q again and again. And I'll keep doing it till what I get? Till what I get? Balanced condition. Okay. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Suppose yourself at this point. Suppose yourself at positive terminal of battery. How much potential you have? V, right? Now you move here. You have V potential with yourself, right? Now you start moving through blue resistance, P color resistance. When you were entering into the P resistance, you had potential V. When you are entering, you have potential V. Now, how much potential did you spend? How much potential you spent there? I1P. So, how much potential? Correct. How much potential is left at point A? V minus I1P. Correct. If you take this. If you are moving from this way, you had V voltage initially, but how much will you spend? How much will you spend?
V minus I2R.
I2R. So when you reach that, when you reach that B, how much potential you are left with? V minus I2R. I2R. Okay. Any doubt in that? Now, if bridge is balanced, IG is zero. If bridge is balanced, IG is zero. And you reached at this point, suppose. You reached at this point. This point means negative terminal of battery. And we can assume negative terminal of battery means how many voltage? How much voltage?
Zero.
Zero volt. Means at point B, you have some money. At point B, you have this much money with you. So you will be spending entire money here. You will be spending entire money here. So that at this point, you have zero money. You understand that? You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Same as applicable for Q. You have some money at point A. When you are crossing Q, you will spend your entire money across Q. So what you will get at B? What is your left at B? Zero. Now, let's put everywhere IG is zero. In balanced condition, circuit will look like this. At balanced condition, circuit will look like this. This is P. This is R. This is Q. This is S. Q को सीधा बनाना पड़ेगा. This is Q, okay? And there is no current flowing through galvanometer. There is no current flowing through galvanometer. So if I current is entering, I1 is going through P and I2 is going through R, an entire I1 will go through Q, an entire I2 will go through S because there is no current going through galvanometer. Do you understand that? Do you understand that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So potential here is I1, P, and potential here is I2, R. Potential here is I1Q and potential here is I2S. So, if you want to keep potential at point A and B same, this is point A and this is point B. If you want to keep potential at point A and B same, then I1P must be equal to what? I1P must be equal to what?
I2R.
Great, very good, very good. Because when you spend same money, then only you will left with same amount of potential at A and B. At A, you have V minus I1P. And at B, you have V minus I2P, I2R. So if I1P and I2R are same, if I1P and I2R are same, then only you may get equal potential at A and B. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
and at this point is connected with the negative terminal of battery. Okay, this point is connected with the negative terminal of battery. So here we have 0 volt. So you will get 0 volt here only if I1Q and I2S is same. Now, potential at point A and point B is already same. Okay, now you spend entire potential across Q when you are coming from here. You spend entire potential across Q, that is I1Q. And you spend entire potential across S, that is I2S, then only you'll get 0 volt here. Okay? Can I write I1Q must be equal to I2S? Can I write
yes.
I1Q?
Yes, I2S?
Otherwise, how will you get 0 voltage? You have potential at A and B already equal. You have already potential A and B equal.